Well, she was a free spirit who loved mischief, but when trouble came calling last night in Excelsior Springs, it turned deadly.
Today, Kat Thomas's body was found miles away in Elmira, Missouri. Tonight, KMBC 9's Jim Flink is back live where four people are in custody. Jim?
Yeah, Larry, Kat Thomas was watching movies at a friend's house here in Excelsior Springs last night when she decided she needed a ride home, so she placed a call to someone she knew quite well. That turned out to be a final, fatal mistake.
I'm going to miss him. Are we all going to miss him?
Under the canopy of a park shelter house with crying all around, carnations and candlelight couldn't soften the mood of an entire community grieving.
It's been rough, but, you know, just kind of trudge through it.
Barry Allen was Kat Thomas's stepdad. He helped to raise her.
I heard about a old woman had been kidnapped and, you know, and I didn't know it was her.
Her, who was kidnapped here on Myrtle Avenue just blocks away less than a day before. Today, police found Kat's body in a farm field miles away, arresting or detaining four people.
I've known her since she was like 10. She went to school with my son.
Susan Lynn says Kat was watching movies at her house last night around 10 when she called someone she thought was a friend to take her home.
She came up and gave us a big hug and said, I love you and I'll see you later. And come to find out, my oldest son said she was scared to leave. She really didn't want to go with the ride.
That fear would prove prophetic. Alexis Clay grew up with Kat. Everyone knew she liked mischief.
If she would have had a couple more friends that would have tried to steer her away from the stuff she was in, she wouldn't have been in the trouble that she was in.
No one knew just how big the trouble was.
We're all gonna miss.
Tonight by candlelight, people talked about the spunky woman who caused trouble but made them smile.
And she just really,
go ahead and speak, Mom.
Really was just a joy to be around.
Now, this is a crime that spanned three counties, the murder scene in Ray County, the abduction scene here in Clay County. All the suspects were taken into custody in Clinton County. One final note, Kat leaves behind a child she had given up for adoption about 4 years ago, a child she continued to visit right up to her death. We're live in Excelsior Springs tonight. Jim Flink, KMBC 9 News.
All right, Jim, thank you. And police have not released the names of the suspects. They tell us they will release more information in the morning.